song. La, la, roar, la, la, Smurf the whole day long.
Smurf along with me. Simple as can be.
Next time you'll be in blue, just let the smile begin.
Hi, I'm Samson, and I would like to know, can you tell us about a few famous stunters?
Okay, probably the most famous of all the stunters was a man named Blondin, and he was from France, and he came over to Niagara Falls, and in 1859, and again in 1860, he crossed the gorge on a tightrope walk, and he did it several times, and each time he wanted to get a little bit more daring to get the crowds to come and watch him, and so One time he carried his manager on his back. Another time he took out a cook stove and he cooked something on top of the stove, on top of the wire in the middle of the gorge. So he was probably the most famous one. The next famous, most famous, would be Annie Edson Taylor. And she was the first woman to go over Niagara Falls in a barrel. And she did it on October 24th of 1901. And as I said before, the stunters have to be a little strange in order to do this. So she had a barrel made in Bay City, Michigan. She brought it to Niagara Falls. And she tried to get into the water above the falls a couple times, and she got caught. So, because it was not legal to do stunts. And so she finally snuck out into the water. A couple people helped her. And she got inside the barrel. And she had an anvil, which is this big piece of iron that they used to make horseshoes. They attached that to the bottom of the barrel. She went inside the barrel. And she went over Niagara Falls, and she lived. And she wanted to get rich by doing it, but she never did get rich. So she used to spend the rest of her life going around trying to talk to people about her stunt. She sold a book about going over the falls and what it was like. She sold postcards and pictures of herself, but she actually died in the poorhouse. And she got buried, instead of being buried in the poorhouse without a grave, people from Oakwood Cemetery down on Portage Road paid for her grave, and another group of people paid to have her headstone made. And they actually do tours of stunters. There's several stunters in Oakwood Cemetery, and they do tours there. Okay. There were others. There were people that went through the rapids. There are people that went over the falls and anything from a rubber tube to like a canister that kind of looks like a propane tank. And they've done the stunts all the way up to last month when Nick Wallenda came, and he went over the closest to the falls that anybody had gone on a tightrope. And he had to walk through the mist. Everybody else who went over on a tightrope was further down the gorge and didn't get all that mist from the fall. So those are probably the most important. But there's probably about 50 or so stunters that came, all different ways, either through the rapids, over the falls in some contraction, or tightrope walking, those kinds of things.
I'm Angel, and I'd like to know, what are the most popular materials in the local history department?
Well, some of the most popular things are the yearbooks from the school, from the high school, because when they have reunions, they want people to come back, and so they look up the pictures to get everybody's name, and then try to find them. Sometimes when they have the reunions, they copy the photographs of the class activities, or even the senior pictures of the class. And when I had my class reunion, we wore a copy of our senior picture so that people would recognize us because we change as we get older. So that's one of the things that we have. And this is a 1950 yearbook from LaSalle. So that was actually a long time ago, but there's pictures in there that we get to use whenever people come in. And sometimes when people are looking for people who used to live in Niagara Falls and they know what school they went to, like if it was their grandparents or maybe their aunts or uncles, then they look in the yearbook. So that's a very popular thing. But probably the next most popular thing are the city directories. And these are like telephone books, and they list people by name in one section and then by streets in another section. So if you wanted to know who lived on your street in all the years that the street was built, or who lived in your house, you can look those up. And again, if you're looking for somebody in particular, you can find them in the name section of the city directory. You can even find out what they did for a living, where they worked. And then there's another section too that you can, if you have a phone number and you want to know who the phone number used to belong to when you had real phones, not cell phones, when you had the landline, then there's a whole section that lists them by telephone number. Then we also have old newspapers. So we have about 3 years of old newspapers, so if you wanted to read the Buffalo News or the Gazette, if you wanted to look up something, like when Nick Wallenda came, if you wanted to start from when he first announced he was going to walk across the tightrope, then you can go back to those newspapers and you can look up every single story that was written. You can do them on the internet for the most recent things, like Wallenda, but how do you do it if you were trying to look up something from 1902? There is a catalog of newspaper articles by subject. So you, if you wanted to look up stunters that went over to Niagara Falls in a barrel or on the tightrope, then you would look under stunters, and then it would give you the name of the newspaper, the date, and the page number, and you could go back and look at those old papers on microfilm, which are on pieces of tape, and you put them in a machine and you get to read them that way, because we don't have all the old newspapers. We have some, but not all of them, because newspapers are made out of a very acidic paper, and it destroys itself. And so we copied everything on microfilm, and you go downstairs and use the microfilm readers, and if you want a copy of it, you can print it out.
Where are you originally from, Laura?
Well, I was born and raised in Niagara Falls, New York.
Okay, where did you attend high school and what is your major in college?
I attended high school at Niagara Falls High School. I attended all 4 years of high school there. The new high school, there was an older high school, but I attended school at the new high school. And my major in college, my undergraduate major was English Literature. And my major now as a grad student is digital rhetoric and professional writing, which is basically professional writing, any kind of professional writing that's not about books and not so much about journalism, so everything in between. That could be copywriting, it could be grant writing, and they teach you a lot of digital skills so that you're more marketable when you go out into the job field, since that's what's hot right now. So.
Did you enjoy your time at the teen club at the library, and have you learned anything new?
Yes, I definitely enjoyed my time, and I learned a lot of new things. I actually teach first-year writing at Michigan State, so this was kind of my first time, outside of some stuff I do with my church, this is my first time really getting a chance to be hands-on with teens and technology. And youth and digital media is my passion, so it was a great time. I learned a lot of new things, especially things that working with the teens, things that they taught me. You know, of course you can always teach others, but you have to be open and understand what people teach you too. So I learned a lot of cool things from them too.
Okay, what do you expect to see in the teen club in the future?
I expect great things. I expect a lot of growth. I expect to see just more teens, especially from the community, being able to come in, have a place where they feel comfortable learning about new technology, where they can bring their ideas and feel comfortable carrying out things that they want to do. I just expect a lot of growth and a lot more involvement from the community, and just I see, you know, great things coming from this program.
Okay, what year are you graduating from college?
I graduate in May, next May actually, 2013. So I'm almost finished, one more year of graduate school.
And one more question, where do you see yourself in 10 years in the future?
Wow. In 10 years, I see myself definitely successful, so you gotta start there. I have two career paths I'm looking at right now. One of them is going on to get my PhD and possibly being like a college professor. And another one is finding like a corporate company to work for and maybe work my way up in the company. So those are the two options I'm kind of battling with now. But outside of all of that, I know that one day I will start a nonprofit organization that works with youth in digital media. That's my passion, so I know that'll be kind of my baby, the thing that I do no matter what my career is. Even if I can make that a career, that would be nice as well. So I know that that's something that I'll do in the future.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Stars shine.